weeks on there. It was a 28 mile cycle, and this guy's sounds. I mean, there's loads of stuff to be done here. List, and they literally just said go for it and pick what you want to do. Alright, it's market day, and I was going to cycle, but the weather's decided to rain, which is apparently a rarity in Turkish summer. But check these scenes out. This looks pretty cool, man. Help if there wasn't water on the lens. Cool mountain rain scenes going on. I've got to sort the chickens out before I go. So these are the little chickens. One's just jumped out, so it's a clever one. The other white one will follow. Oh, there you go. Sue, go on. Go on. Go on. Go on. Oh, bracing. Ah, nearly. Cool, so this is a little village called Kurtkoy. And Kurt stands for wolf, and koi stands for village, so wolf village. And I'm getting the bus from outside the mosque into town, so interesting little bus ride, I suppose. It's like a little family on there, man. They're all chatting to and from with the bus driver and that, and then stopping off at random stops to do milk and bread deliveries and stuff like that, so a bit random. But yeah, gonna try and find the bazaar. I sort of know where the bus stop is. Gonna completely forget, I think. Walking up and down and across. Just stuff is all everywhere. I'm looking for a Turkey football shirt. Cool, so I found one in the end. This guy here. There you go. Yeah, he's going to hold it up for me. There we go. 10 lira. So, 3-4 quid for that. And he didn't have it in the reverse colours, but I thought, you know what, that's nice, I like that. And then the guy down the road, he said, no, no one in here will have the international shirts. And this is the man. Cool, so I've been assigned a bit of a beast of a task. And I've already started in here. So there was a massive crack that ran all the way along here and down there. So what I've done is I've chiselled them all out and filled it and that. But in here, it's a bit worse. So, and it runs all the way into the bathroom. So, got a Kango, metal piece. I'm literally gonna rip it apart, fill it with cement, and then when it's all done, nice coat of paint on all of it. Pretty good. Sam, so I'll oh my god, it's cracking already. Shouldn't be doing that. Put in this resin stuff, so it's solid now. It's like some sort of fibre resin. Just mixed up a load of cement. And I'm gonna stuff this with it. Cool, so thought, you know what, I'm breathing in dust all morning. So this is the this is Troy's the dog number 3 out of them all, and we're going to go for a little walk in the stunning Turkey mountains and get some fresh air. And it's nice and hot. It's like I said, 31 on the floor, and that was in the shade, so this is in the heat now. But quite a cool little walkways around here. I went for a walk with the other dog yesterday, but my legs were knackered from all the walking in the market and cycling here the day before. It's just like I couldn't manage it. So I think we'll go for a longer stretch today. Alright, so these are the Kurtkoy beehives. There's more than just this section here, because all the farmers have got their own scattered around the place and they feed them. Oh my god, it's in my hair, man. It's actually in my hair. Oh, can you... Ah, it fucking stung me. Bastard. Sort of stung it. Ah, in the head. Right, anyway, step a bit further. That's the reason why I wasn't going to film yesterday. Oh, it's still going through, man. Right, to be continued. Right, I'm actually in quite a bit of pain now. I've actually been stung on the crown, and it's killing. Right, anyway, the reason I didn't want to film them yesterday is because the beekeepers were there, smoking them all, and they were going mental, and I didn't want to get stung. You know, thinking, oh, yeah, can have a little chat about them, we'll be safe. And I stand there, I get stung on the head. Check this brute out. Big ass mean dog. Shouldn't really be testing my luck, seeing as I just got stung by standing near bees, and now I'm trying to film an angry dog. Which food? In the pond. It's got to cool down the freshly cooked broth, shall we say? Bowls of gruel. Nice. Alright, I never knew this, but avocados, right? Yeah, it's avocados, yeah. No, artichokes. Artichokes, right? And when the plant, this is like the old ones here, so they've all been chopped off and eaten, and then they die down and they regrow. But this is what the head of one looks like when it blossoms. First little task is to sort these things out. And for you wondering who they are, they are the support structure for the poly tunnels over there. And the ends have come off. So I've got to grind off the end of them and then make some new ones out of this scaffold and wire brush it down and tack them with a welder. So, easy. Alright, so I finished those little welding and painting jobs, and with those poles, this is what the structure looks like when you need to go. There you go, weld and paint. You can build a big tunnel like that, and then put a sheet over the top, store wind inside, dry it out through the sun, with the extra heat from the sun, and then that's it, you've got storage in that. So this is the farm that I'm on, anyway. Well, this is the lower field, there's an upper field, but this is the lower. Everything's eco-certified, so it's all green, you know, solar-powered, grow your own stuff, and strawberries, artichokes, plants, the lot. So yeah, it's pretty cool. It makes me think, like, what if this place costs 70, 80 grand, that's pounds, so 300,000 lira, and I've got all this, and it's just mad to think that everyone at home, or when you're out at home, you know, you're in a job that if you're lucky you can get like 30 grand a year, and all you do is pump loads of it into a mortgage and you don't get anything out of it. You spend your whole life working to turn around at the end and get a pension. It's like, why don't you just take 80 grand and build a pension where you don't need to buy anything, you can survive solely on what you've got because you've grown enough and produced enough that it just reproduces itself. Crazy, man. Makes you think. Well, it's made me think anyway. You fucked it. Hey. Look at that, his tail's just come off. It's still wriggling. Cat versus lizard. Oh, and there's. Oh my god, look, there's the full length of his tail. Chance of surviving. Just give you a little insight to what I've done this morning. So just finished the repairs on this side. And now I've just ripped all these tiles off because this crack that runs down the side runs into the cupboard above here, down here, down here, stops there. Carries on behind here somewhere, there, into the next room. So, basically just ripped all that off now. And I'm just gonna resin in here. And then cement the whole thing, but it doesn't need decorating in here because, I mean, it's just a guess thing, but have a look in the toilet and you can see the damage. And the reason why it's doing this is because there was rushing water underneath the gaff. So that's all been extracted, but now there's a space to fill. So every 6 months the gaff drops, and that's why the pond is at an angle and everything over here is at an angle. But until it settles, you've just got to keep doing the patch-up repairs, so, which I'm happy to do because I don't mind doing that. Easy task. Check this out. Double tick on the face.
Yeah. No, really, man. Let's have a look at your eye. Don't hide away.
Arr, 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 arr. I'm gonna clean them up in a minute. The other two have jumped in sound, but these two are a little bit slow.
Boyfriend.
What are you gonna do? Look at this one. What? What was that about? Any more in there?
No, that's it.
Got the one egg. That's a bit random. Still going for it?
Yeah.
Lazy sod, that's what it is. Yeah, random. It's been sat in there all morning. So you just picked up. One day old little chicken. And this is a new project of mine at Helpx, and my little student. Say hello, Amit.
Hello.
What are you doing?
I am 13 years.
And what are you doing here? What am I teaching? What are we learning?
One
1 minute. What are we learning? What are we learning? What subjects are we doing?
English.
So yes, we're doing English. Progress update. 2 coats of paint. There you go. Come out. And and I've rebuilt this because it had a big chunk missing out of it, so it's squarish. Is it filming?
Yeah.
Right.
Wait.
Oh, look, no, he's picking him out. Look.
How do I?
Is look, it... he's picking him out. Or is he going in there?
Yoo-hoo, where are you?
No, look, I'll get another one out. I'll get this one out.
Actually, this is kind of cute.
So we're having fun with bees at the dinner table. The kitchen table. Right, here we go, this one should fall out now. It's alive!
The first thing you see as a baby bee is honey.
Yeah, look at them. You need to shoo them out though. Look. Let's have a look, how much time's left?
48.
Cool, I'm gonna show you the honey under it.
He spread his wings a little bit like this.
Yeah, man.
This one. They're a little bit like dizzy or something.
Nice, eh? Impressed. So now I've finished all the internal cementing and painting works. I've now been given the outside to do, and I've already made a start on it. So I've repaired all this ledge here and sorted all these cracks down here. This has still got to be filled out some more. And now I'm just working on knocking out this wall, and I'm going to have to repair up here. And then this is going to slope down like that, and I'm going to rebuild all of this with cement on a slope and then lock it into there so it looks nice. And then I think this could be my last job, but who knows, I'm still waiting on my passport, so you know, it's been out of my hands now for over 2 months, and I'm just waiting for it to come back, so I'm going to India. Get in. Anyway, I'll you know, keep you pleasurably updated.
Update for you.
3 days since the last one, and this is what I've been up to: cementing, build a wall. Look at that! Look at that for accuracy, man. And putting these tiles down. So that's the next phase: is to prime and seal all behind these, and then cut each one to fit and build a ledge, and that's the plan. So yeah, coming along nicely. 3 days. Yeah, just a little update. Slapped the coat of paint on and cut all these tiles individually, and yeah. Looking sweet, I'm liking it. Morning, so just following on from the other day. We sort of finished that. At this moment, you need everything. Where is it? I haven't got anything.
Bye.
10.